Tanya, Tanya Billy and Mr. Richard Seaver to come forward and perform a traditional welcome for us.
Our guests, our parents,
parents, and our families tonight's ceremony. Tonight we reach an important milestone in life. Our young men and women in the class of 2019 who have been supported by their parents, families, and teachers over the past 13 years are about to embark on a new journey, a transition in life, one where we become independent, take on new responsibilities, and many of us spread our wings and fly far from our comfortable nests to make our own way in this world. Graduates, tonight, as you walk across this stage, you are passing through a doorway, and we are all so proud to witness you taking those steps. At this time, I'd like to make some formal introductions. Behind me is a party platform, or on the platform party, is our school board trustee, Mr. Jared Mumford. And our admin superintendent, Mr. Rohan Rohan-Progresso. Our principal, Mr. Chuck Lawson. And our vice principal, Ms. Lisa Ego.
Memories. Reflect on your options. Do something that you're super passionate about. Far too many people in my generation count out the days to retirement instead of enjoying moments they spend at work. Remember, your time on this earth is very special. And the time you spend away from your family must be spent on a task that really excites you and makes you come alive every single day. So as you embark on a career choice, take your time to reflect, choose wisely. Engage in a career that fulfills your soul, excites you every single day, a career that you're passionate about. The second part of my message is about practicing kindness while you uphold integrity. Can you recall a time that somebody was super kind to you? Move into your heart and feel what you felt at that time. Your feelings. Did it touch your soul? In this fast-paced world, kindness and compassion takes a backseat to selfies, self-interest, and expendable human interactions. Every person is going to be discovered or become rich believing it holds the key to their happiness and complete fulfillment. Yet when they attain success, they long for their former life, having underestimated the trappings of fame and celebrity. Kindness is fundamental to human existence. We are thrust into the world as newborns and enriched with the kindness of our parents, nurturing for the ensuing years. Humans are the only mammals with a prolonged gestation period. Other creatures rely on support for a brief time before becoming self-reliant. We are powerless at birth and depend on our caregivers to provide for our needs. Therefore, kindness is sown into the framework of our DNA. We are literally wired for kindness. Every person has opinions on how to improve the world, though no one wants to practice kindness in their own backyard. World peace will not arise from overthrowing dictatorial powers by ending conflicts between nations. It'll happen when humanity raises its consciousness beyond that of fear and hatred and embrace the beauty of diversity and inclusion, where race, religion, gender, sexual orientation, age, socioeconomic status, visible and invisible disabilities are celebrated. Students, you are our future leaders, and you have the ability to have a big impact on shaping humanity to create a world full of peace, love, and happiness. I wish to leave you with a message from Mother Teresa's poem titled Anyway, in which she states, "People are often unreasonable, illogical, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Be kind anyway." Finally, to quote Mark Twain, "Kindness is a language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see." Congratulations, G.W. Graham Secondary School Class of 2019. We are proud of you, your accomplishments. Have a great day.
Thank you, Rohan. Before we move on, I just need to back up for a second. Can I have the G.W. Graham staff please stand up? And as I sat here, and I looked out over the crowd, it hit me, right, because we were middle secondary school, and we just became a secondary school this year. But all of you guys sitting there, you've been under their loving care for half of your educational experience. Guys, you've been with these guys for 6 years.
As some of you might know, I'm the trustee liaison for G.W. Graham. For those of you who don't, I'm the trustee liaison for GW Grammar. Having gone to high school here in Chilliwack in the 90s, I'm quite familiar with CSS since I'm a senior, but it wasn't until a few months ago that I actually ever stepped foot into your school. When I visited, I was amazed, truly I was amazed. The opportunities that you guys have there and what you've made of them is truly awing. So, to talk about opportunities, your administrators provide you so many opportunities, alternate delivery of education, because they know that every one of you is different and your path to success is different. You have an amazing trades department, obviously, big opportunities there. Incredible theater, great opportunity there. And of course the staff who are willing to work those extra hours to create opportunities for you in athletics, arts, academics, citizenship, volunteerism, and so on. The list goes on and on. So when I tell people about the school, and I do talk about the school to friends and family, I frequently mention the school's successes. And the response is always the same. It's, wow, those kids are so lucky to go to this school. I kind of disagree. It's true, there are amazing opportunities at GW Grammar, amazing opportunities. But an opportunity is nothing more than disappointment if you don't recognize it, embrace it, and follow it through to success. Graduating isn't easy. It's not easy. It wasn't easy for me. It wasn't easy for anyone here who's graduated. GW Grammar gave you the opportunity to graduate. Some of you had an opportunity to be in an award-winning school band. Some of you, an opportunity to build a bridge on our nation's trail. One that will last for decades, by the way, it's a beautiful bridge. Some of you had the opportunity to be part of amazing productions and be on championship caliber sports teams, to become leaders in your school, and so on and so on. You recognize those opportunities, you embrace those opportunities, you rolled up your sleeves, you fought through the anxiety of going to school, those late night studying, which I'm sure some of you at least did, and you graduated. So it started with an opportunity and you earned a success. You earned it for you, for your peers, and your school. So I say, you're not lucky to go to this school. This school is lucky to have you as students. Give yourselves a hand for all your successes up until now.
Middleton, Katie Lynn, and they will be
another round of applause.
So on stage, just wave to everybody, we have Mr. Liam Sheriff. amazing. A couple of acts there. Like to give a special thank you there to Mr. Gertzman, who was on the keyboard. He opened this classroom up every lunch period so these guys can get together and practice. And there's a lot of younger students that practice with him as well. So thank you, Mr. Gertzman.
Come on.
Thank you, Ms. Cote, too, for putting that slideshow together and taking us all on a trip down memory lane. Up next, we have our beloved principal, Mr. Chuck Lawson, who's going to come forward and give the principal's address.
In class of 2019. The late Steve Jobs said, innovation is the ability to see change as opportunity, not a threat. The ability to see change as an opportunity, not a threat. Class of 2019, I believe you're graduating a very exciting time, and you have a lot of changes ahead of you. More changes than I've ever faced, more changes than your parents have ever faced. I'm very confident that you're ready for those changes. I believe that's going to lead to opportunities and excitement for you. One of my favorite educators, Yang Zhao, challenges the education system. He says we have to shift a bit, not completely, a bit from the traditional system that focused heavily on preparing youth for jobs and careers. Because we have to focus on a creative mindset. We have to re-energize music programs. Not, hey, we have a dynamite program here, don't worry. We emphasize music programs, emphasize the arts, emphasize personalization of learning, emphasize supporting youth working with their hands and working with their minds collaboratively. Class of 2019, I've had the pleasure of watching for the last couple of years, and for some of you before that, years coming to the gym and music programs. By watching that, I am confident you're ready for facing change. Because things I've seen is I've seen you stand tall with a swagger and a confidence. I've seen you believe in yourself. When you believe in yourself, others believe in you as well. I've seen you perform with passion, pride, and spirit. Most of all, I've seen you being you. And when you do this, I believe you will get success. I'm going to share a couple brief examples that I've seen over the years. I can share many. But again, Rohan said only 5 minutes. A couple years ago, I was at the Langley Music Festival, and I had the pleasure of seeing a jazz band perform, and they performed a song called Back Row Politics. And in the song Back Row Politics, what happens is the trumpet players, they stand tall, they grab their music stand, their music, and their trumpet, and they move forward to the front of the band. At that performance, I saw them stand there, they're doing stretches, they're getting all ready to perform. Last time I checked, I don't think you need to stretch to play the trumpet. But there was a swagger, there was a confidence. They didn't even play a note, and I knew something special was happening. So when you move forward and you face change, I want you to have that swagger. I want you to have that confidence. Go into your interview and say, hey, I'm here to answer your questions, but I'm gonna do a few stretches first. A couple jumping jacks. I'm ready. Class of 2019, on our gym walls are the words, pride, passion, and spirit. Those words permeate through to all our athletes. I see passion when you practice. I see passion at provincial championships. I see passion when you play in our gym, in our field, and on the track. Passion, passion, passion. In the theater, again, this year we had to play willpower. And we had sword fights, we had romance, we had humor. The performance was outstanding. And in that case, there was an intensity and there was a passion that the performers radiated out to the audience and throughout the theater. Class of 2019, most importantly, when you face change and you face challenges moving forward, I want you to be exactly who you are. On behalf of the staff, I should give a Graham. I got a little choked over here. Fun with you. We've seen your playful side. We have fun playing together. We've shared laughter. We've enjoyed your intensity, your drive, your work hard, your bright individuals. You'd be in calculus class, and you'd want to get 95%, and you're still there cheering on your friends. But you'd be happy if they maybe got 94, because there's a little bit of competitiveness in you. Most importantly, we know you're kind, considerate, and genuinely caring individuals. You volunteer throughout our community, you volunteered at GW Graham, you've done everything to make our community and GW Graham better. So thank you for that. Class of 2019, I wish you all the best for the future. I thank you for representing GW Graham. That's it, I lost my breath. Well done. There was one more line in there. That's all right. It is my pleasure to call upon three wonderful students. They're going to give a tribute to adults, to parents. To have Ty Hall, Deidre Lee, and Max Bergen come forward.
Together, the bond between we the students and you.
you, the teachers, have been critical for us to succeed. Now being finished high school, there's an overwhelming sense of gratitude for all of you who pushed us to get our work in and try our best. It may have seemed annoying to us at the time, but now looking back, it is not only needed, but also greatly appreciated. The teachers that we have at GW Graham are not your average teachers. They're willing to stay after school and help us with our work, pick us up when we're down, and lend an ear. School is not only a place that we have to be, but we want to be. Whether it be Mrs. Barrow and her silly biology jingles to help us understand that cells, they're made of organelles. Mrs. Go-To and Mr. Abraham, the joyous duo of the English department, have taken so many of us, from average writers to spectacular scholars, with their constant and unwavering support. Miss Goss, respectfully known as Mother Goose, has not only showed us the lay of the law, but have given so many of us so much to talk to in times of need. Mrs. Dick and Miss Henderson are always willing to spend the extra time to help their students understand the most challenging math concepts. And Mr. Muckman is a true legend who has not only led our senior concert band, but has chaperoned many of us hooligans on trips around the world. Miss Wiseman has shown so many students their future careers and possible job opportunities. And our counseling department has always made sure that we're on track to graduate. Each and every teacher in the GW Graham family has similar stories in ways in which they've helped mold us into the young men and women we are today. It's not only teachers that have guided us. GW Graham wouldn't run the way it does without our incredible admin team. Mrs. Ego and Miss Gibbs only joined us this year, but they immediately became part of the GW Graham family. Finally, there's the man himself, Chuck Lawson. When you see him in the hallway, he's all smiles. He's caring and compassionate no matter what day of the week it is. The school wouldn't run the way it does without his leadership and hard work. From the teachers to the administrators, the library staff to the EAs, the custodial staff, the counselors, and the ladies in the office, all of you play an equally important role on our lives. Thank you all for making our school years so great. On a side note, I love you, Grandma.
Whether it be the urgent voice in your ear as you make your way down the field, or the reassuring nod as you toot the trumpet, coaches and mentors, in one way or another, have impacted many of our lives. The amount of time these adult figures have taken over their own lives to help us succeed in ours is something that we will never be able to repay. Whether it be sports, music, or theater, the majority of us have been a part of the school in one way or another. All this would not have been possible without the coaches and mentors to guide, teach, and run these activities. The endless hours they have put into running these programs, the hours they have poured into making our visions and dreams possible, is something that we'll be forever grateful for. These people were the rock behind the scene. Whenever we had a long day at school, or nothing seemed to be going our way, we were able to go and all these frustrations into the thing we love. Where everything else seemed to fade away, and it was just you, the thing you love doing. I'd like to take a moment personally to thank an important coach and mentor in my life, Mr. Mortensen. He began coaching me in grade 11 as a new student at GW Graham, and over the course of 2 years, he brought a group of boys together, and over the course of a year, made us a family. From running the dreaded 17s at 6:30 in the morning to celebrating a provincial birth, Mortensen has always been there for me, as an athlete, student, and as a friend. Nearly all the students at GW Graham have been positively impacted by the coaches and mentors at the school. Whether that be through sports, music, theater, or other activities, it was all possible because of these amazing coaches and mentors in our lives.
Whether it's reassuring us after we had a bad dream,
or celebrating with us when we finally mastered a new skill,
or cheering us on from the sidelines, the important adults in our lives, our parents, guardians, school staff, coaches, and mentors have had an undeniable role in helping us get to this point.
So for that, we say
thank you.
you're representing all of the adults in this building. And your kind words. Okay, grads, now's the time that we've all been anticipating. But before we have our presentation of the class of 2019, there are a few instructions that I need to review. Stage, stare, photo, and rose ushers, and other personnel, can you please take your positions now? Parents and guests, please be reminded of the photo etiquette. Free 5x7 photos are being taken and sent to your home this summer, so photography will not be necessary. So please don't distract from the ceremony. You don't need to get up and take pictures. We got that. Graduates, please be reminded of the stage procedures we practice. After you receive your portfolio from Mr. Rubregazzo, receive a flower and shook hands with Trustee Mumford. You will then shake hands with Mr. Lawson, who will move your tassel from the right side to the left side. The moving of the tassel from the right to the left signifies the recognition of earning a degree. Once your tassel has been moved, you will have your picture taken with Mr. Lawson with a vibrant photo. Afterwards, you'll be helped down from the stage by an usher and directed back to your seat. Please remember to hold your folder, your portfolio, at hip level. Would staff members reading anecdotes please come to stage left? And can we please send the first two rows of graduates to the rear hallway where they can line up for the presentation?
Jonathan Angus.
Edmund Archer.
Camera.
Thank you to her family and friends who inspired her every day to keep doing what she loves. She achieved ARs this year and is the recipient of the Bookman's Literature Lovers Award and the Chilliwack Foundation BC Summer Games Legacy Award. Cindy Castro.
Joshua would like to thank all the teachers, employers, and peers who helped shape him into who he is He achieved A honors and is the recipient of the Gwen Point Aboriginal Education Bursary, Stawell Nation Bursary, Enbridge Foundation Award, UBC Centennial Scholars Award, Propel Engineering and Trades Award. Joshua Diebel. I would now like to welcome Mrs. Tammy Chernoff to the stage to read the next set of graduate names.
Thank you. for everything, Emily Finch.
Award.
wants to travel the world. He thanks his parents for their love and support. Nate Hall.
She is the recipient of the Royal Canadian Legion Branch No. 280 Ladies Auxiliary Award and the District Authority Award for Physical Activity. Megan Helen. Paige Helen. Paige intends to get her Bachelor of Science degree in nursing at UFB. She thanks her parents for all their support. Paige achieved A honors this year and is the recipient of the Rider Lake Farmers Institute Bursary, Royal Canadian Legion Branch No. 280 Ladies Auxiliary, District Authority Award for Physical Activity, and the BC Senior Girls Field Hockey Association Scholarship. Paige Helen. Jackson Howard. Jackson will be attending the Glenn Gould School of Music for Trombone, which will help him achieve his aspirations as an orchestral musician. Jackson is one of two top senior music students this year. He is also the recipient of the Berklee College of Music Entrance Scholarship, Emily Jansen Memorial Scholarship, G.W. Graham Music Department Scholarship, Glenn Gould School of Music Entrance Scholarship, UBC Entrance Scholarship for the Music Program, and the District Authority Award for Fine Arts. Jackson Howard. Sam Hoyer. Sam intends to travel Europe after he graduates and then attend post-secondary to obtain his degree in criminology. Sam Hoyer. Billy Wong. Billy would like to thank Mr. Simington, and all of his teachers for teaching him the value of hard work and determination. Thank you, Billy Wong. Jenna Imbury. Jenna intends on traveling after graduation and afterwards plans to attend UFB to study psychology. Jenna Imbury. Julia Ingram. Simington for always supporting her and pushing her to achieve her goals. Julia Ingram. Jeevan Jande. Jeevan thanks his parents and coaches for all of their support over the years. He is the recipient of the Rotary Club of Chilliwack Scholarship, Jake and Sarah Moore's Bursary, Dalhousie University Men's Basketball Scholarship, District Authority Award for Physical Activity, and the Smiles by Design Bursary. Jeevan Jande. Sierra Jensen. Sierra is overwhelmingly grateful for the support of her teachers and peers. In the fall, she is excited to spend 10 months continuing her education in Spain. She received A honors this year, as well as the award for the top senior English student. She is a recipient of the Mount Shiem Canine Association Bursary, Chilliwack Hospital Auxiliary Bursary, Lewis Washington Memorial Bursary, UBIC Excellence Entrance Scholarship, and the Rotary Youth Exchange Scholarship. Sierra Jensen. Jordan Joe. Jordan would like to thank his family and the G.W. Graham staff and teachers for helping him get here. I love you, Mom and Dad. Jordan Joe. Adam Kadir. Take this. stairs instead of the elevator. Adam Kadir. Dylan Jensen. Dylan is looking forward to furthering his career in welding. Dylan Jensen. Mason Keller. Mason appreciates each and every one of his teachers for putting up with him. Mason Keller. Micah Keller. Micah plans on attending UFE for the electrical construction program while continuing to make music on the side. He thanks everyone who has supported him through his high school journey. Micah is the recipient of the District Authority Award for Fine Arts. Micah Keller. Grace Kennedy. Grace intends to obtain a Bachelor of Political Science degree in pursuit of fulfilling her dream of becoming a family lawyer. She achieved A honors this year and is the recipient of the UBIC Entrance Scholarship. Grace Kennedy. Rose Katka. Rose would like to share her quote, "We are the universe experiencing itself." Rose Katka. Kellyanne Kickert. Kellyanne would like to thank her mom and her teachers for supporting her over the years. Kellyanne will be attending the University of New Brunswick for a Bachelor of Philosophy and Interdisciplinary Leadership.
Thank you. Sarah Kerbach. Sarah attended UAB for her Bachelor of Science degree and eventually intends to have a career as a pediatric orthopedic surgeon. Sarah Kerbach. Madison Krug. Madison intends to get her Bachelor of Science degree and begin a career in biochemical engineering. She thanks her family and friends for their support. Madison is the winner of the Chilliwack Minor Fast Pitch Association Award, the QP Local 458 Harry Pallet Bursary Award, and the Hap Hepner Bursary. Madison Krug. Brianna Langstaff. Brianna wants to get a Bachelor of Science degree in nursing. She thanks her parents and teachers for helping her get here. Brianna Langstaff. Trent Larson. Trent intends to work in the trades industry. Trent Larson. Jake Lawson. Jake thanks all of the wonderful teachers and coaches at GW Graham for their endless support during his high school years. Jake achieved 8 honors this year and is the recipient of the Mount Zion No. 120 Masonic Lodge Bursary. Jake Lawson. Deirdre Lee. Deirdre would like to thank her parents and teachers for their never-ending support and for helping her throughout the years. She is the recipient of the Board of Education Award. Deirdre Lee. Tiffany Lee. Tiffany shares a quote from Will Rogers. Even if you're on the right track, you will get run over if you just sit there. Tiffany achieved 8 honors this year and is the recipient of the Optimist Club of Chilliwack Scholarship. Tiffany Lee. Quinn Leaping. Quinn plans to travel to Europe and Eastern Asia after graduation. Quinn Leaping. Kaylee Langert. Kaylee thanks her family and friends for their unwavering support. She also thanks Mrs. Coteau and Mr. Monkman for always being there and helping her whenever possible. Kaylee is one of 2 recipients of this year's Top Senior Music Student Award, and also won the Sardis Kiwanis Club Mel Osborne Youth Scholarship and the District Authority Award for Fine Arts. Kaylee Langert. Taylor Lewis. Taylor thanks Mr. Wolford and Mrs. Bax for always supporting her, as well as her family and friends. She wouldn't be here without them. Taylor Lewis. Mingyang Lee. Mingyang plans to attend the University of Victoria to study chemistry and to travel back to China to visit. Mingyang Lee. Andrew Locke. Andrew plans on attending UFB while continuing to play football for the Valley Huskers. He thanks his parents and coaches for pushing him to be his best self. Andrew Locke. Mackenzie Lutz. Mackenzie will be attending Langara to earn a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree in photography. She is the recipient of the Chilliwack Dogwood Monarch Lions Club bursary, Mackenzie Lutz. Kathy Liu. Kathy will be pursuing her passion for science as she studies at the University of Victoria, working towards earning her Bachelor of Science degree. She thanks her family for their unconditional love and support. She achieved 8 honors and is the recipient of the following awards: the Kiwanis Club of Sardis Al Bernard Memorial Music or Agriculture Award, the Knights of Columbus Chilliwack Council 3478 Bursary, Beta Sigma Pi 11 Gamma Lambda Bursary, District Authority Award, Community Service, Rotary Club of Chilliwack Scholarship, G.W. Graham Pack Bursary, McGill University Entrance Award, University of Victoria Excellence and Entrance Scholarship, Chilliwack Foundation John and Joy Helders Arts Award, Kathy Liu. Isabella Macaluso. Isabella thanks her teachers for inspiring her and helping her to achieve her post-secondary goals. She has been accepted into the CSS Hair Program and looks forward to fulfilling a career in the industry. Isabella Macaluso. Kennedy Mammel. Kennedy plans on attending TRU for a bachelor's degree in criminology. She thanks her friends, family, and Mrs. Muscle for their endless support. Kennedy Mammel. Benza Manes. Benza plans to attend the UAB for a healthcare assistant program, after which he plans to further his education and become a registered nurse. Benza Manes. Chloe Mastin. Roger Matt. Roger intends to get his heavy-duty ticket at UAV and see how far a career in drilling and blasting can take him. Roger Matt. Jacob McCormick. Jacob thanks his family, Mrs. Goto, and the boys. He will be pursuing a Bachelor of Arts degree in Communications. Jacob is the winner of the Board of Education Award and the Ionic Kent No. 19 Mason Lodge Bursary. Jacob McCormick. James McCormick. James plans to get his Bachelor of Kinesiology degree at UFV and eventually become a physiotherapist. James McCormick. Madeline McCullough. Madeline will be attending the University of Victoria for a Bachelor of Education degree, and she intends to become an elementary school teacher. She was given the top senior science student award, and she also won the top overall academic award for 2019. Additionally, Madeline is the recipient of the following: the QP 411 Local Bursary, G.W. Graham Administrator's Bursary, the UVic Major Entrance Award, the BC Pathway to Teacher Education Award, a Hobby Hill Preschool Bursary, and a District Authority Award for Fine Arts. Madeline McCullough. Devin McGregor. Devin wants to thank her friends and family for being her support system throughout school. Devin McGregor. Jayla Meyer. Jayla plans on attending the University of Victoria for a Bachelor of Science degree and will be pursuing a career as a nurse practitioner. Jayla achieved 8 honors this year and is the recipient of the Chilliwack Hospital Auxiliary Bursary. Jayla Meyer. Carson Melia. Carson would like to thank his parents for teaching him the value of hard work ethic and determination. Carson Melia. Gavin Michaud. Gavin will attend UFV and complete a Bachelor of Kinesiology degree. He wants to thank his friends and family for their endless support and encouragement. Gavin Michaud. Cooper Middleton. Life is like jazz. If you get lost, just keep singing. Cooper is the recipient of the Youth Work and Trades Award. Cooper Middleton. I'd now like to welcome Ms. Courtney C. to read the next set of graduate names.
Douglas Miller. Katie Murphy. Kylie Amiro. Kylie would like to share a quote. To believe in an ideal is to be willing to betray it. To follow anything absolutely and unquestioningly is to see it worked beyond recognition. Kylie Amiro. Tiza Nahan. Dennis Nastasi. Dennis would like to thank his friends, family, and teachers for helping him achieve his goals. Dennis Nastasi. Zachary Newman.
Pharaoh plans to pursue a Bachelor of Science degree at UFE. He is the recipient of the Aboriginal Advisory Committee Award. Pharaoh Priest.
She would like to thank Mr. Ault and Mrs. Coteau, and also Mr. Larson and Mr. Longhurst, because grade 7 teachers never get shoutouts. Carolyn Peterson. Jacob Peterson.
Matthew Ryan. Matt intends on starting a career in the mining industry, leading to his dream job as a driller and blaster. He thanks everyone at GW for helping him through his educational journey. Matt received the Courage to Persevere Award. Matthew Ryan. Brady Roach. Brady Roach. Ryan Robert. Ryan would like to thank his parents, Mr. Abraham, and of course, Dude Stew. Owen Rollman. Owen intends to get his red seal in welding. He'd like to thank his family and friends for all their love and support. We made it. Owen Rollman. Valerie Rumsey. Marcos Sahamis. Marcos thanks his family and friends and hopes to go to BCIT for a career in computer animation. Marcos Sahamis. Ryan Seabrook. Riley Zebra. Farron Seaman Woodsworth. Farron thanks her family for all their love and support. Farron Seaman Woodsworth. Taya Seaton. Taya Seaton. Aiden Sharlow. Aiden intends to take a year off before attending UFV to pursue studies in criminology. Aiden Sharlow. Liam Shearer. Liam wants to pursue his dream of being a jazz performer while studying at Grant McEwen University. He thanks his teachers and coaches for all their years of support. Liam is this year's recipient of the Top Senior Fine Arts Award. Liam Shearer. Tegan Shepherd.
The song.
Felicia Tajerski. Felicia plans on going to U of D to get her Bachelor of Kinesiology degree, which will eventually lead to a job as an occupational therapist. She achieved A honors this year and is the recipient of the Dr. and Mrs. Froese Award and the District Authority Award for Fine Arts. Felicia Tajerski. Brandon Tenbos. Brandon thanks his friends, family, and teachers for making high school great. He is the recipient of the Youth Work and Trades Award. Brandon Tenbos. Ashley Scissor. Ashley wants to thank her dad, Mama C, and her teachers for spending countless hours helping her through her school years. Thanks for always believing in me. Ashley is the recipient of the following awards: QB411 Local Bursary, Royal Canadian Legion Better Golden Branch No. 280 Award, District Authority Award for Physical Activity, and the Chilliwack Fire Department Charitable Society Award. Ashley Tizzard.
Yeah!
Mark thanks his family, friends,
to do his best. Cole is the recipient of the BC Principals and Vice Principals Association Scholarship, the G.W. Graham PAC Bursary, the District Authority Award for Physical Activity, and the Red Deer College Athletics Men's Basketball Scholarship. Cole Wicker.
Congratulations to the class of 2019. And next, I would like to invite to the stage a young man who was chosen by his peers to be
Please welcome Mr. Liam Audette.
I'm talking about our scholarly heroes, the teacher.
years. First and foremost, the always amazing Mrs. Coteau. You only started teaching me this year, but as soon as I walked into your class, you welcomed me in with open arms and have been my at-school mom ever since. Thank you for going outside of your job description to make sure students like me succeed and are happy at the end of the day. Speaking of going outside of your job description, Mr. Foltz! Yeah! Man, you are a theatrical machine. You're like Yoda, and I'm Luke Skywalker. Except you've never made me give you a piggyback ride through a swamp while you make me advice on acting. But it's never too late for that. You're always pushing me to better myself, and I hope I made you proud. I mean, when was the last time we had a theater kid as a valedictorian? I mean, come on, you know? Thank you for everything. Lastly, I'd like to thank Mr. Kevin Alt. Oh, Captain, my captain. Ascended teacher level, or somewhere up there with the great legends of our time, such as Mahatma Gandhi, John Lennon, Mike Myers, Kermit the Frog, you know, best of the best. In all seriousness, you came at a time in my life where I was struggling the most with who I was and who I wanted to be. But you showed me my potential and encouraged me every step of the way. You went above and beyond as my teacher, and I thank you for that. Confident that bits of you and all the other absolutely outstanding teachers in GW Grimm will be incorporated into the way I teach the next generation of students. Especially big thank you to the amazing teachers and staff we have at GW Grimm. One of these teachers, though some past and some present, have guided me through my time here at GW. You're all very important to the reason I have succeeded and I'm up here today. You know who you are. I'd like to thank you all collectively for going above your pay grade and changing my life. I cannot stress this enough. The school has the best teachers and staff in the district and deserves so much more praise than I can give them right now on this stage. Thank you so much for your hard work, dedication, and support. We love you guys. If you're looking for somebody to cast Prince Charming on your men, it's Brimble. Thanks, Brimble. Alrighty. Next one. Cole Wicker. Good stuff. Why are you gasping? I'm being told that your basketball skills are going to rival none other than Michael Jordan's acting skills in the 1996 film Space Jam. Another one, Taya Seaton. Good stuff. All right. You're on track to become Hollywood's next big star right here.
Yeah!
Yeah, yeah! Just please don't accept any offers to star in any live-action Disney remakes.
What's Shrek?
Shrek is DreamWorks. And if you do, make sure it's Lilo and Stitch. You play great Stitch. Anyway, we've talked a lot about what's to come in the future, but how about we already talk about what we've accomplished this year? Sound good?
Yeah.
First of all, let's give ourselves another round of applause. Well deserved. Now, let's start with our outstanding Key Club. The Key Club has not only worked so incredibly hard for our school and their community, but they were awarded Distinguished Club Status and awarded Service Club of the Year with the whole Pacific Northwest District. That's amazing. Let's give them a round of applause. Next, I've got to mention our fantastic leadership class and student council. You all put in the extra work to make sure things get done, and done pretty damn well. Thank you. Thank you for bringing back school dances. It was fun. Now, our amazing school athletes. From the senior varsity girls basketball team coming in second at the basketball provincials to the senior varsity boys basketball team coming in seventh for the basketball provincials and the senior varsity girls coming in 10th. Oh, wait. Fact check. What did they come into? Was it 10th? Thank you, perfect. Now, we're talking provincial, as in like, all of BC. That's pretty amazing. Let's give them a round of applause. I couldn't go without mentioning our thriving trades program. They spend hours at Pycroft learning the place like the back of their hands, and work with BC Parks to build accessible cabins at the Maple Bay Campground. Personally, I love camping. Ooh, that was loud. So, thanks for that. Alrighty. Now, I'd like to talk about some of the unreal accomplishments our Fine Arts Department has made this year. The senior jazz band went all the way down to our neighbors in the south to compete at a jazz festival where they raked in countless awards and spread the good word of how truly talented us Canadians are. The film department had its very first Chilliwack Student Film Festival hosted at our school, which will surely become a staple at GW Grand for years to come. And of course, the theater department blew expectations out of the water with its total of 10 stage productions, most notably Willpower, The Passion and Violence of Shakespeare, which is one of, if not the best, stage production GW Grand has had, but also SD33 as a whole, I may humbly say myself. It's been an absolutely smashing year for all of the departments and groups mentioned, and I couldn't be more proud of the work my fellow students and staff have put in to make sure that all these accomplishments came to fruition. And parents, you better be taking your kids out for Dairy Queen after this. They've done some good work. I'd like to mention a few people that grew up with us as a grad class, who are not here across the stage with us tonight. Lucas Munksgaard and Trevor Thompson. We all miss you so much and treasure our memories with you two very dearly. They're in a better place now. A place with beautiful landscapes as far as the eye can see. It's as wide as the clouds above us and home to extremely cheap gas prices and low taxes. I'm speaking, of course, about Alberta. Thank you, Lucas and Trevor, for all the memories and great times. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you. I think we may be the kindest, closest, and most ambitious grad class GW has ever seen. I think about the fact that as a grad class, we raked in over $600,000 in scholarships and bursaries speaks volumes. That's a long nonchalant. Never have I heard such high praise of any grad class, ever. I mean, just ask the teachers and staff. They love us, and I can assure you they're so proud of who we've become. You're a wonderful group of people, and you should be so, so, so proud of yourselves. This grad class is, and always has been, like a big old happy family. Brothers and sisters, you know. And I'd be lying if I didn't say Mrs. Cotu and Mr. Abraham are cool, hippie parents. Mr. Simington is our lovely and hip uncle. Mr. Beal is our second cousin, who always has the craziest stories and makes the best homemade butter. It seems like that kind of guy. And Mr. Fultz is like our great, 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 great grandpa. We love him. We've all grown up together, and it's going to be a big adjustment not seeing each other every day. We really are a family. But we'll never forget the time we spent here with each other. These experiences will last us a lifetime, aiding us in our future endeavors in the outside world. You all are capable of so much, and I cannot stress that enough. I skipped a part. Each and every one of you has the potential to change the world in your own unique way. I hope you all realize your potential. And if not yet, I hope this speech can get you that much closer to realizing what you're truly capable of. Because we're all capable of a lot more than you can imagine right now. With time, I hope you all realize what kind of heroes you can be. Kelly Spriggs, enriching lives as a physician. Emily Finch, bringing joy and empathy to others through her music. Jordan Dick, protecting and fighting for our country in the military. Carolyn Peterson, teaching young readers important life lessons through her novels. Maxwell Bergen, risking his life to save others as a firefighter. Woo! And Robbie Corp, inspiring others to explore new worlds as a digital artist. Woo! We'll all be heroes in our own right. Give everybody a mention, a round of applause. You're all amazing. I would have mentioned you all if I could. That I've gone for a very long time. You've been sitting a very long time. So I'll move on. Now this day has been coming for years. You can't fight it, so embrace it. Life is a beautiful thing. There's no need to be afraid of its changes. You're all capable of such amazing things. Each and every one of you. So get out there, seize the day. Now, to quote the legendary David Bowie, of course, we can be heroes just for one day. We can be us, just for one day. Make us proud, but most importantly, make yourself proud. I know you will. I love you all so, so, so much. The world has never seen the likes of us before, so better get ready for the GW Grand Grad Class of 2019! Now, the moment you've all been waiting for. This is the part where I ask you all to throw your caps up in the air in celebration. Are you with me?
staff for their support and the time that they spent volunteering to make this a successful grad year and a successful class of 2019. Can we please give a round of applause to show our appreciation? And I'd also like to say thank you and recognize all the staff that are working behind the scenes, backstage, organizing, and a special thank you to Ms. Coteau, Mr. Simington, and Ms. Fisher, who organized tonight's convocation ceremony. And as we prepare for the closing of tonight's ceremony, please note the following procedures for a quickly and orderly dismissal. So I need to give some instructions here. Alright. The gown retrieval people need to take their positions in the gymnasium now. The main floor monitors need to take their positions now as well. The dismissal order will be as follows. The platform party will exit first, down the center, followed by the staff and VIPs, then the graduates will come out, followed by the audience. Graduates, as you march out the back and are led into the gym to return your gowns, you're asked to stay in line in alphabetical order at all times. And please do not leave the building without returning your gown. This concludes our convocation ceremony, and now we begin the celebration of the class of 2000.